Hi, it's Nikki Joel from Focus TV, and I have just had the most fabulous time sitting down with Shandi and Susie, Miss USA's, and also of Pageantology.com. And girls, what is that fabulous slogan that I love so much?
Defining the modern beauty queen.
So come on and tune in. Hi, it's Nikki Joel of Focus TV, and I am sitting down today with Shandi and Susie, Miss USA's 2003 and 2004, and I am definitely not the hottest one of this trio, but I am in good company. So, it's nice to meet you guys.
It's nice to meet you.
Real life Miss USA's. So, first, what's it like to be a Miss USA? How does it feel?
You know, I'm incredibly grateful for the year, not only because of the year and you get to do all these awesome things and travel not only the United States but the world, and you get to raise a lot of money for breast cancer research, which we both raised over $30 million separately.
So is that your choice charity?
No,
or
it's
you?
Every Miss USA champion.
Every Miss USA is breast cancer. Wow, that's incredible. I was taking a look at your site and I was really, really blown away. First of all, aesthetically, it really grabs you. I mean, just the name and the way you did the branding and everything.
Thank you.
So how did that come about? I know you guys, you crowned Susie,
or I know, yeah.
Susie crowned Shandi. Okay,
yeah.
And you guys became friends, which is a big deal, and you've sustained.
Not right away, because I crowned Shandi in 2004, so I was Miss USA in 2003, Shandi was in 2004, and we kind of switched, right? So Miss USA, there's an apartment, the title holder apartment.
No, I think that it's like a sorority house, right?
It sort of is, actually.
A lot of people don't realize that in this apartment in New York, Miss USA, Miss Teen USA, and Miss Universe all live together.
Yeah. What I want to know is, growing up, I knew you grew up in the South and you grew up on the East Coast. Did you early on start doing, you know, these kind of pageants and beauty contests? Like, how does this start? How did this come about?
For me, it didn't start till I was about 17.
Wow.
And I had a postcard that was sent in the mail, I'm sure to just a mass group of young women, and said, come compete in this pageant, and they had a talent competition and a speaking competition that I really wanted to do.
More than the beauty part of it.
Yeah, because I had had a really short, really awful haircut. Like, I wasn't what I thought to be, like, a beauty queen. But I really enjoyed playing the piano and doing public speaking, and so I entered this, it was the American Co-Ed Pageant is what it was called.
Meaning there were boys in it, too?
No.
Oh.
I know, everyone says that. I'm not sure why
Co-ed.
It was called that. Exactly. And I ended up being third runner-up out of, like, 100 women or young girls, and didn't think anything of it, and a woman came up to us afterward and said, that's really great accomplishment. This is our first pageant. You should continue it. But I only saw it as a hobby, an expensive hobby, where you would sign up for a pageant and go get a dress. And it wasn't until I really got into my early to mid-20s that I saw it as a career move and how it could really be a pedestal to launch me into other things and open up so many other doorways.
So how did it start for you, Susie?
Well, I started modeling when I was like 14 years old. I had my little modeling agency in Boston called Dynasty Models. And
good name.
Isn't that good?
Linda Evans, here we come.
I remember a friend of mine, you know, I had all these modeling pictures and a portfolio and stuff, and my best friend in high school was a subscriber to Teen Magazine, and at the time, Teen Magazine did this great model search.
I remember it.
Do you remember that?
Yeah.
It was huge.
I remember that.
She's like, Susie, we should send in your pictures and see what happens. I was like, do you know how many girls enter this thing? Like, I'm not going to win this thing. She's like, well, let's just try. You have your pictures. We went to the print shop. We, like, did copies of my modeling.
There was no emailing JPEGs back then.
You had to, like, mail everything. I remember going to, like, the post office. And
mom and pop.
This 8x10 manila envelope, you know?
Right.
And I sent it in, and I ended up being one of the lucky national finalists. They chose 12 girls to go to New York City. We spent a week at the Waldorf Astoria, did the whole thing. At the end of the week, they crowned their winner and their first runner-up, and I ended up being the first runner-up.
That's amazing.
It was insane, yeah. So when I got back to Boston, my agent at Dynasty was like, if you could get second place out of the thousands of girls that enter this, you should try doing this pageant. And for me, I wanted nothing more than to work in the entertainment industry as an actress, as a host. And he's like, if you win this...
It was a great stepping stone for you.
Well, like Shandi was saying, there's such tremendous opportunity in pageantry.
If it's done correctly. Because there's some girls who don't see past Saturday night, meaning... They see the crown, they want to win, and then that's it.
Right.
And that's fine too.
But you guys really maximized because you did go on to do the hosting and the...
It was just a tool to get us somewhere.
So you decide to start Pageantology. How did that come about?
Well,
and what is Pageantology?
I had been coaching a couple girls here and there on my own. just whenever I had free time, and just because it is such a passion of mine, if a young girl, because I remember when I was competing, the first few pageants, you don't know your ass from your elbow. Like, you really don't know what you're doing. And I remember they said that you had to have, like, skin-colored heels. And I remember coming out in these, like, bronze-colored, big, cloggy things. You just don't know what
right.
is appropriate, what looks good. You don't know your own fashion and styling. And it's a whole beautiful way for young women to kind of just grow themselves into the woman they're going to become. And so I was kind of helping girls along the way. And then Susie and I were getting together for lunch one day. She'd just gotten back from judging the Miss Massachusetts pageant. Because we still judge a lot of
right.
state and national pageants. And I said, what did you think of the winner? And she said, you know, honestly, I mean, she's beautiful, everything is great, but I felt like a couple of the girls were just missing a few things. Like, if one would have just done a little bit more of this, or a little less of this, or not done these little tweaks that could take you from getting 6, 7, 8s to 8, 9, 10s. And I said, I totally know what you mean. And so we were having actually a vegan lunch.
Yes, you guys are vegan. I and if that's going to make me look like you, then I'm going to go hit one of those raw restaurants right after this.
So I said, what if we just start doing this together and just sharing? And as we start talking about our experiences, we have such similarities where I had competed at Miss America in 2002, and she had competed at Miss Teen USA a few years before she won Miss USA. And neither of us succeeded in that area, where we both sort of thought that we were going to, and that was going to be our outlet to something bigger. And because we didn't, that sort of drive
to work harder, achieve the next
no
one.
No stone unturned. So that way, when you're standing up there, if you weren't called, it's not because you could have done anything differently. And so we saw these similarities, and we said, why don't we put this together and share this knowledge with young women? You know, yes, definitely for beauty pageants, but also just for life.
Well, confidence and holding yourself and the self-esteem aspect.
We even have some girls who attend our workshop who have never been in a pageant and never plan on being in a pageant.
So how do people hear about you and know that you're doing coaching? Like, is it something that, for example, the pageants talk about? Are they offered to different girls because you've kept in contact still with the people that run the pageants? How do you get your people?
We've partnered with a lot of the state directors for the Miss USA and Miss Teen USA pageant. And so Shandi and I, with Pageantology, we sponsor like the Miss Hawaii USA pageant, California,
great.
Alabama, South Carolina, North Carolina, Virginia is a new one, Massachusetts.
There's a lot.
Yeah, there's a bunch. We're currently the sponsor of about 9 or 10 state pageants. So,
and that's in addition to actually judging the contest too, correct?
Well, we don't judge.
If we work with a girl in a state, then we don't judge.
No, because it's a conflict. Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
But that's how.
So.
And by the way, and you sort of mentioned our slogan, which is on our.
I love your slogan. It's like.
Yeah. Well, because for the longest time, I remember telling Shandi, I'm like, I really hate the term beauty queen because, and Shandi and I talk about this all the time. When we were Miss USA, we'd go to an event, and I mean, I can't tell you how many times people are like. Oh, I never would have thought that you were a beauty queen. And I hate the word beauty queen.
Well, it's really archaic. It's so archaic.
Yeah. And so that's why our slogan is, we're defining the modern beauty queen.
It's a great slogan. It really jumped out at me. What do you think makes somebody stand out enough to be crowned? What are those secret ingredients?
Well, what we tend to do, if we have a one-on-one with the girls, we sort of do a really quick evaluation of what are they lacking in and what we'll take them to the next level. And it usually ends up being one of two things, which are kind of, they work together. And one is just interview, having the confidence to speak. How does she speak? How does she move her hands? What does she believe in? Why does she believe that? Can she support it? And then also, what is her brand? And they kind of go together. Brand meaning, who are you? Why did you even enter the pageant? You don't just say, well, I just want to wear a sparkly dress. Okay, well, then you may not be cut out for the job. But if you are there for a specific purpose and you're using this, even if it's not because you want to go into entertainment, we had, like, one woman who wants to open up a men's fashion line, a boutique, and she wanted to use all those contacts that she makes and, like, the fashion world and all the connections to be able to help launch that. So really defining who you are and finding out your brand. And we, a lot of times, girls are like, I don't know what my brand is. And we have to kind of talk them through it.
And help them create a brand.
And help them create it. And then they have confidence now in the interview room because it doesn't matter what they ask you, if they say,
well, you've prepped them on the questions in a way.
Yeah. And they then drive the interview. So they know what message they want to get across. So it doesn't matter what they're asked, they're able to get it across. And we've been really fortunate. The past two Miss Teen USAs, we've actually coached all the way to winning the crown.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Tremendous success.
I mean, you know.
What a, like, billboard advertisement for you guys. So in addition to looking beautiful, what are your favorite tips, products, conditioning treatments? I want to know what I need to be as close as I can to be the two of you.
So you want to have clear, fresh, beautiful, like glowing skin, but then also for life, because that's the thing that's going to prevent us from aging the most is taking care of our skin. And where that really lies is, yes, what you put on your skin, but mostly what you put in your mouth.
And so do you drink a lot of water?
Yeah.
It's hard.
There's a lot of fluids going on in our lives.
Yeah.
Well, we have the red
thing, like green juices.
Oh, yeah.
We put chia seeds in water with turmeric.
Yeah.
But do you guys drink wine ever?
Oh, my.
Okay, good. Just checking.
Every night.
Okay, and coffee?
This is my vitamin.
And coffee?
I had 2 cups of coffee.
Okay, I feel so much better. So we don't have to quite get rid of all those things.
Everything in moderation, but we certainly do. Well, I don't know about Shandi because she loves her wine.
Wine is a vitamin in my.
I agree. I agree. Are you kidding me?
It's like
wine o'clock somewhere. So let's switch to beauty products. What are your favorite hair products, skin moisturizers, makeup, beauty products? You're going to a desert island. What do you have to take with you?
So I think we can both agree we would definitely take a huge jug of coconut oil. I also I really love this hair product that I've been using for a while called It's a 10.
Oh, I have it.
Yes. Don't you love it?
The Miracle, the leave-in conditioner?
I don't have that one, but I have 2 different other conditioners. One's in a little pot, and
yep.
One's for blondes,
yep.
Specifically.
Yep.
It takes out brassiness.
Yep.
I just love it because it doesn't weigh your hair down, and it's just really gives your body or your hair all the body that it needs.
What are your favorite makeup brands?
I love pressed powders with like a buffer brush to just kind of buffer the powder in.
Yeah. And I like I use Armani. Like right now I have Armani.
I have it. 5.5. It's the best.
Really?
The Luminous, I have it.
Okay. And then for everyday auditions and things like that, there's an SPF in it, the Jouer.
Oh, brand. Yeah. And I love the compact that you build the little creation with. It's like a Rubik's Cube.
I don't have that.
Oh, my God. It's amazing.
And then, of course, my favorite blush on the planet, which is so popular.
With Orgasm.
Artist, is Orgasm.
Orgasm.
Yep.
So I could talk to you both for hours, literally hours. I could go get cocktails with you. I could go shopping with you. And I want to be your best friend. So what would be your final thing to say, and where can we find you, and what's your next big picture?
I would say my final thing to say is just for people, man, woman, old, young, no matter what your life goals are, but to be really mindful of everything you put in your body, meaning food, like just be clean so that way when you go out and you do eat pizza and nachos and whatnot,
okay.
Your body can handle it better, but also what you put into your head, what you watch on TV, what you listen to in your car. I just think it's so important, and more studies are being done that when you watch awful, like, killing movies or, like, even the news sometimes before you go to bed, how that really impacts how you sleep. So just being mindful of everything that goes in so that everything that comes out is of the best.
And you? Well, and you, Susie?
How about, I mean, I think that's perfect. I think you asked where people can find us.
Yeah.
Where, so pageantology.com.
Okay. I love that name. It's awesome.
It's the science of pageantry.
It's so good. And don't forget the slogan.
Yeah, you're right.
And I think what you're doing is amazing, and I'm excited to continue to watch it, and it was so great to sit down and talk to you. And this is Nikki Joel.
Is it wine time?
It's 1 o'clock somewhere.
That's what I meant.